I loved John Wayne movies as a kid. I still do. If I'm flipping around the channels and there's a John Wayne movie on, you bet I'll stop just for a little bit, and sometimes to my wife's chagrin, for a long time to watch the same movie I've seen dozens of times before. Back in the day, my buddies and I would take our quarter for the movie, our nickel for the popcorn, and our nickel for pop, and we'd head to the theater for John Wayne's latest Western epic. And I guess I just dated myself a little bit right there. But watching that movie was just the beginning of the fun, because for the rest of the weekend, we would be running the neighborhood, recreating the action and imitating our heroes. We all wanted to grow up to be like John Wayne. We wanted to walk like him. We wanted to talk like him. We wanted to act like him. And Pilgrim got pretty good at it, too, after a while. But some of us even got so that, you know, we could do that and have people actually know who we were trying to impersonate. It was a lot of fun, but no one ever confused us with those figures on the big screen. And I thought about that as I read Paul's words from his letter to the church in Philippi, where he said, "Join in imitating me, and observe those who live according to the example that you have in us." You know, I always wonder about people who set themselves up as examples for others to follow, and I find myself thinking, just who do you think you are? And that's a fair question. Who did Paul think that he was? How did Paul see himself? Well, if you back up just a little bit to the beginning part of chapter 3, where we read our scripture from this morning in the letter to Philippians, here's what Paul writes. He says, "If anyone else has reason to be confident in the flesh, I have more. Circumcised on the eighth day, a member of the people of Israel, of the tribe of Benjamin, a Hebrew born of Hebrews, as to the law, a Pharisee, as to zeal, a persecutor of the church, as to righteousness under the law, blameless." Seems to me that earlier in his life, Paul really had it going on, and he knew it. He would have had every reason to lift up those credentials and to challenge the Christians in Philippi to follow his footsteps, like they or any of us ever could. But before you make up your mind about Paul, and before you accuse Paul of being pretty full of himself and having an attitude, read on just a little bit farther. In verse 7, he writes, "Yet whatever gains I had, these I have come to regard as loss because of Christ. More than that, I regard everything as loss because of the surpassing value of knowing Christ Jesus my Lord. For his sake I have suffered the loss of all things, and I regard them as rubbish in order that I may gain Christ and be found in him." Paul saw his work experience before knowing Jesus really to be a liability rather than an asset. It's all trash to him compared to the joy of knowing Jesus. And that's what Paul invites us to imitate when we think about the way that Paul lived. What do you think about this whole idea of living your life imitating somebody else? Living out your life as a reflection of somebody else's life. On the surface, it seems to fly in the face of good old American individualism. But I think we kid ourselves if we think that individualism is something that all of us naturally strive for. For the most part, I think we're more comfortable when we fit in instead of when we stand out. Advertisers know that. They cater to that herd mentality. They know that most folks are looking to be part of something bigger than themselves. And so they market products with that thought in mind. And that's why we have fast food restaurants from coast to coast. The majority of people don't like surprises when they go out to eat. They want a Big Mac to look and taste the same in Georgia as it does in California. When we travel, we don't want to be surprised by things that are different. Is that the kind of imitation that Paul is looking for? Do we really want churches to all sound alike, to all look alike? Or do we want to stand out so that people will be in awe of how unique we are? And the answer to both questions is yes. All Christian churches, no matter what their denomination, should look and sound alike in terms of the way that we all claim Jesus Christ as our Lord and our Savior. That is the common bond that unites us. That is what makes us all one church. We claim that Jesus Christ is our Lord and our Savior. And that's the Lord that Paul chose to imitate in his life. Everything else was set aside. Everything else was reprioritized as Paul came to understand what it meant in his life to follow Jesus. And God is constantly calling us to examine ourselves and to check out our baggage. Most of us are carrying, I think, way too much junk. We have so many possessions that our possessions soon begin to possess us. And we have a hard time letting things go. We just redid a closet at our house. And the result is that we have a much more orderly situation with everything in its place and a place for everything. Maybe I should replace that. A place for everything that we need, and everything we need is now in its place. It's amazing how much junk we accumulated in a relatively short time. I was stunned to find how slacks and jeans had shrunk from not being worn after being in the closet for a while. And so we cleared out a lot of the junk, a lot of that stuff. They were no value to us anymore, but we made sure that they went to some place where somebody else could get use out of them. What we had was taking up space and getting in the way. And that's what Paul did with his life as well. He went through and he took an inventory and he got rid of anything that was a hindrance to his relationship with Jesus Christ. That included his titles. That included his status as a religious leader in his community. That included his accomplishments. He threw all of that out in the trash and he started over with a clean slate. And then he turned to the Christians in Philippi and he challenged them to follow his example. He challenged them to imitate him as he followed Christ. As we journey in Lent, it's a good time for us to do the same thing. It's one thing to empty out a closet at home and separate the junk from the treasures. But how do you do that with your faith? Sometimes it's just a process of realizing that we all imitate someone. We all look up to someone and we are all followers of one cause or one ideology or another. But do we take time to look at those connections and see if they are at all times compatible with what we believe? Do we examine ourselves to see if we can carry all of those commitments and still have room in our lives to carry the cross? And if the answer is no, then what are we going to leave behind? And how do you go about making those choices and making those decisions? Would it surprise you to know that you're right now sitting smack dab in the middle of a research laboratory? What better place could there be to look at the faith that you have and think about the decisions that you need to make that affect the way that you walk with Jesus every day? Paul invited church members in Philippi to use him as an example as they were making choices and decisions about their faith. They'd seen Paul in action. They'd heard Paul preach. They'd read his letters, and they felt the passion that he had for Jesus, and he became a role model for them. And in a way, he's a role model for us too. His words and his fire can touch us today, can guide us today as we hone our lives to show Jesus to the world. But we also reflect that love of God to each other. And I would invite you to give that some thought this morning. Who might be looking at you this morning, here in this place, for some clues for living a Christian life? That can be a sobering thought, can't it? And it doesn't matter what age you are. We have a great situation here in the church where our older teens have become mentors to our younger teens, and our older youth have become mentors to our little ones, and we're taking that seriously about taking folks under their wings and nurturing their faith and bringing them along. And the great part is that everyone in the church grows in their faith and the church becomes stronger for us. Our youth are modeling that for us. And it doesn't stop with the kids. When you are all worshiping together on a Sunday morning, you truly do become role models for one another as you reflect Jesus. We all worship the same God. We all claim the same Lord, but we experience His presence in so many different ways. When we share our experiences together and when we model what Jesus means for us to each other, we get a more complete vision of not just who Jesus is, but also who God calls us to be. And we share that with each other whenever we come to worship. I'd like to think that when we read in our bulletins that all members of Gilbert Presbyterian Church are ministers, that we take that seriously. When you read through the annual report of the congregation, it becomes pretty clear that there are a lot of people who are involved in the life of this particular church. No one person is lifted up as the role model that everybody should imitate. The congregation is not being transformed into the image of its pastor, thank goodness. And this congregation does not reflect the faith of a specific few spiritual leaders or any one particular person. We all have something to add to the mix as followers of Jesus Christ. We all share who we are as children of God, and we learn from each other in the process, and together, then we begin together to resemble the body of Christ. How can we tell how we're doing with that? If you're involved in any way with Facebook on your computer, you're always being asked to answer 5 questions. There's all sorts of different quizzes that you can take. You can take those 5 questions, answer them quickly, and then you'll know which dead president shares your pessimism, or which old school comic book superhero happens to have everything in common with you. And you'll get something like, "Congratulations, you have anger issues like the Hulk." "You're prone to patriotic acts of heroism like Captain America." Information that you just can't live without, right? Plus, through the power of social networks like Facebook, you can share the results with everyone else on the planet, and they will know that little bit about you. No, as of now, there is no quick 5-minute quiz that can tell us how we're doing in becoming like Christ, how we're giving our impression of Jesus to the world. Maybe one way to gauge your godliness is to simply take a quick glance at what's in front of you and a short look at things behind you. And then think for yourself whose footsteps you're following in today and what's coming from those who are walking in your footsteps. That can be a sobering experience as well, because chances are you'll be convicted by what you see, or by, more often, what you don't see. But don't be discouraged if you don't like what's in front of you or things behind you that resemble you. Then simply look at the cross of Jesus, who is our Savior and who is our example, because in His grace, you've already been forgiven. Now go and do the same and impress the world with the love that He has shared with you. Let us pray. Gracious God, as we gather here this morning in the shadow of the cross that means so much to us, may we think again of the example that You've set for us of self-giving love and sacrifice, the example that You give to us of how we might truly live lives that reflect You to the world, that You might live in us and through us with the gifts You have given to us, and how as a congregation we might come together to be the body of Christ in ministry and outreach. In a nutshell, Lord, that's why we're here, not just to gather with good friends week by week, but to take what we have, learn what You have for us, and then move out to share that good news with the world. We gather here beneath Your cross. We go out there strengthened by Your love. Help us be the people You've called us to be as we journey together. In the name of Christ our Savior. Amen.